Let's do it. I'm Matthias. And sooner or later, you will stand here and it will be recorded and you will have a talk, okay? Sooner or later. And I wish that for you all, okay? Okay, I prepared, this is my second talk for, or third talk, I don't know, okay? For FreeCodeCamp, and my first talk was about setting up and developing a full stack application and so. And this is just a simple talk about wallpaper tessellations. So what are wallpaper tessellations? Actually, that's what you're gluing on the wall, attached a pattern. Yeah, okay. Yeah, and these are repeating patterns found in nature, and you see them on the floor, on the toilet, in the bathroom, maybe on your shirt, in the internet, yeah. And this is a sample for a tessellation like a honeycomb. Next slide. Yeah, there's some more samples. Actually, there's this artist called Escher. Okay, I think he's dead now, and yeah. Actually, he did only periodic tessellations. He went to Spain to see the Alhambra, and he got inspired. Okay, I want to do the same thing, he said to himself, with animals. Okay, and then he drew animals and all other. How it works, okay, you can do this at home, you take a paper, you cut this out, put this there on, with some tape there, and there you have this tessellation, okay, and it's not hard, yeah. And actually, I wrote a program, okay, there's a screenshot, and you will see it soon live, okay. It's just you, okay, I'll show you the, okay, it's time to show you the program, yeah. No, it's full screen. Okay. Hello, nice that you are here, because it was for inspiring myself, okay? And I'm showing how this program is working. So, just mirror it, then I generate the code. Oh, no. Yeah. And then I show this background, yeah. And you can copy this code and, yeah, you can copy this or this code and use it at your homepage. Mm-hmm. And coming back to the presentation. Okay, because it's time for the next, It's time for the next slide, okay? This created, these are some forms I've created with this program, okay? Actually, the forms getting crazier, the less you know how this program works, the crazier the forms, okay? I wrote this thing, yeah. Okay, just you get this code sample from the program, copy the code in and name it, say crazy.svg or, and you have an SVG. Okay, how to use it with CSS? Yeah, okay. Well, your SVG, repeat, and you have it in the background. Okay, it's quite simple. Make use of it in JavaScript. Yeah, that's what you write. Just copy the code, or you can get my slide. It's online multiple times. It's on GitHub. It's on slideshare.net. It's everywhere, okay? Yeah. And you just copy this out, copy and paste it, and it will do it, okay? And that's how it looks like if you take the base64, okay? And I recommend to use it base64 coded because there are those apostrophes and so on, okay? And it's not working, that better you use that. Yeah. Even some students, and I was like, no apostrophes, confusion, easier to generate and change during program execution, cannot be confused with existing code, standard base64 encoders can be used, okay? So you can even take some SVG code and decode it to base64 and then use it in your program. Yeah, that's important, okay? Because you can even contribute to this and you can fork it, link it, make your own, make it better. you can post your comments on Twitter or there, and it's everywhere. Okay. Okay, yeah, I'm finished. Yeah, thank you. I didn't suppose this. That's how you make it big, doll. 12 slides. Okay, nice pictures. Maybe some jokes, and then you're done. Yeah. Yeah.